Good morning to all of you. This is Murali here. We are in the chapter Reconciliation of Cost and Financial Accounts. In the previous class, we have completed with problem number 5. Now we are moving to the next problem, that is a problem number 6. Kindly go through the problem number 6. Okay, this question is asked in the year 2013 for 24 marks, that is there in the semester examination. Okay, kindly go through the problem. The profit as per financial books for the year ended 31st March 2021 is rupees 3,58,000. Okay, yeah, now it is very clear the profit as per financial account is given. Okay, so that means we need not prepare the profit and loss account. The following details are ascertained on comparison of the cost and financial accounts, the particulars and how the amounts are recorded in cost books and how the amounts are recorded in financial accounts, that is given. Stock on 2020, raw materials, work in progress, finished goods, kindly go through the amounts. Then stock on 31st March 2021, raw materials, work in progress and finished stock. Then purchases, wages, factory expenses, then sales, interest received, then office expenses, income tax, then loss on sale of investments, selling expenses. Okay, we need to prepare the cost sheet that should show the costing profit, and we also need to draw up a reconciliation statement on 31st March 2021. Okay, so I hope you have written the problem. Okay, so now we need to start with the solution. One advantage is the profit as per financial account is given, that's 3,58,000. Profit as per financial account that is given, that is 3,58,000. So now we need, that means we need not prepare the profit and loss accounts. Okay, we, that is enough to prepare cost sheet and enough to prepare the, at the final reconciliation statement. Okay, and one thing I would like to clarify here only, you're observing the, kindly observe the amounts of the purchases, wages and sales. Purchase, wages and sales. Okay, how the amount is recorded in the financial books it is recorded as 8 lakh, and wages is recorded as 4 lakhs, and sales is recorded as 22 lakhs. We need to make the purchases, wages and sales are the exceptional here. Don't think it is not written in the cost books and wages in the cost books. We have to consider same amount here as it is given in the semester examination. Even in semester examination question paper also it is given like this, and even textbook also it is given like this. They are not recorded in the cost books. Actually 8 lakh, 4 lakh and sales 22 lakhs is not, you are not observing in the cost account, but we have to take the same amounts at the time of preparation of the reconciliation statement. Okay, that's with regard to the purchases, sales and the wages. Okay, let us start with solution. We need to prepare the cost sheet. The cost of materials consumed. Kindly start. Cost of materials consumed. How to calculate the cost of materials consumed? Okay, one procedure we need to follow every time. Opening stock of raw materials. Then what's the opening stock of raw materials? Opening stock of raw materials is 1 lakh. Okay, You're observing here 1 lakh. That is 1 lakh. Kindly write in the inner column. Kindly write in the inner column, add purchases. Okay, it is enough to write purchases, or you can write purchase of materials. As we are calculating the cost of metals consumed, it is enough to write purchases, add purchases. Okay, purchases. Yeah, I told. Okay, it is given the semester examination also. It is given textbook also. Same. Actually, you are observing the purchase value of 8 lakh and wages value of 4 lakh and sales value of 22 lakhs is not, you are not observing in the cost account. Okay, but these three are the exceptional here. We have to consider the same amounts. Okay, 8 lakh. Actually, according to me, it should be given. You may have a question, why it is not recorded? Why it is not recorded? According to me, it should be given clearly. Actually, in the examination also, actually in the textbook also. So, actually, it makes confusion. It makes confusion. Okay, 8 lakh. So, we need to add 8 lakh to the 1 lakh. So, this is 9 lakh. Now, it is 9 lakh. 9 lakh. Okay. What's the amount? We can go fast, as it is a 6th problem. Now you are aware how to solve the, how to prepare the cost sheet, how to prepare profit and loss account, and even reconciliation statement. You can continue with the solution. You need not wait for me. Okay, less closing stock. You can write full closing stock of raw metals, or it is enough to write closing stock, as we are calculating cost of, as we are calculating the cost of raw materials consumed. Closing stock of raw materials 86,000. That is 86,000. Okay, it should be deducted from the 9 lakh. Kindly deduct 86,000 from 9 lakh. Yeah, this will be, what's the answer? 9 lakh minus 86,000, that is equal to 8 lakh 14,000. That is equal to 8 lakh 14,000. That's with regard to cost of materials consumed. Next thing is about the wages. Okay, only wages means is the direct wages. Okay, direct wages. Write the amount of direct wages. Amount of direct wages 4 lakh. Should be considered same. 4 lakh. It's okay. There are no other direct expenses. We need to go through the entire problem and we need to identify the direct expenses, indirect expenses. But in case of cost sheet, what are the factory overheads, office overhead, selling and distribution overheads that we need to classify? We should be able to classify. Okay, 8 lakh plus 4 lakh, that is equal to 12 lakh 14,000. That is equal to 12 lakh 14,000. Okay, what is this actually? This is actually prime cost. This is actually prime cost. Prime cost is 12 lakh 14,000. And next thing is about the factory overhead. Factory overhead. What is given about factory overhead? Factory expenses is given 4 lakh. You are observing here. This is 4 lakh. Okay, it is recorded same in both the books. 4 lakh in cost book also and 4 lakh in financial account also. So, but we need to consider now. Okay, factory expenses. Factory expenses. Factory expenses. Write the amount of factory expenses, that is 4 lakh. Amount of factory expenses is 4 lakh. Okay. There is an information regarding work in progress. Okay. One is opening, another is closing. Work already in progress should be added. Okay. Work still to be completed should be deducted. Okay. Add opening work in progress. Add opening work in progress. What's the opening work in progress? opening work in progress is 130,000. Opening work in progress is 130,000. That should be added. That should be added. Here, 4 lakh plus 1 lakh 30, that is equal to 5 lakh 30,000. That is equal to 5 lakh 30,000. Okay, and work still to be completed should be deducted. That's what the closing work in progress. Let's closing work in progress. What's the closing work in progress? Closing work in progress is 74,000. Closing work in progress is 74,000. That should be deducted. 5 lakh 30 minus 74,000. That is equal to 4,56,000. Kindly make the calculation by using the calculator. Five lakh thirty thousand minus 74,000. That is equal to 4,56,000. That is equal to 4,56,000. So factory expenses, factory overhead should be added to prime cost. What's the prime cost? 12,14,000. So now the factory cost or work cost is 16,70,000. 16,70,000. What is this actually? This is actually factory cost. Factory cost or work cost. Factory cost or work cost. What's the amount? 16,70,000. 16,70,000. Next is office and administrative overheads. Office and administrative overheads. Office and administrative overheads. What's given to office expenses? Yes, there's information regarding office expenses. Office expenses. Kindly add the office expenses. Okay, we should see only cost accounts. Don't see the information of the financial account. Cost accounts. Office expenses 46,000. What's the amount? 46,000. 46,000 should be added to 16,70,000. Add that 46,000. Now the production cost of production is 17,16,000. 17,16,000 is the cost of production. This is what cost of production. Okay, that's what the 17,16,000. Then is selling and distribution. Sorry. There is information regarding opening finished goods and closing finished goods. Add opening stock of finished goods. Opening stock of finished goods. Opening stock of finished goods. What is the opening stock of finished goods? Opening stock of finished goods is 90,000. That should be added. 7,16,000 plus 90,000. That is equal to 18,06,000. That is equal to 18,06,000. Less closing work in progress. Sorry, closing stock of finished goods. Closing stock of finished goods. What's the closing stock of finished goods? Closing stock of finished goods is 1,24,000. Okay, deduct that. 18,06,000 minus 1,24,000. that is equal to 16,82,000. Yeah, this is actually production cost of goods sold. Production cost of goods sold. Next is selling and distribution overheads. Selling and distribution overheads. Let's give one about selling expenses. Selling expenses. Selling expenses. 90,000. Selling expenses 90,000. Add that 90,000 to 16,82,000. That is equal to 17,72,000. That is equal to 17,72,000. This is actually total cost or cost of goods sold. Total cost, sorry, cost of goods sold. Goods sold or total cost. That's what 17,72,000. Then sales value is given 22 lakhs. Okay, this is what sales. We are getting a difference of 4,28,000. This is what profit. Profit as per financial. Profit as per cost books. Costing profit. This is what profit. What is the profit? Profit is 4,28,000. Profit is 4,28,000. That's with regard to costing books. Financial profit is given, so we need not prepare the profit and loss account. Okay, directly we need to prepare reconciliation statement. Reconciliation statement as on 31st March 2021, particulars rupees. So we can take either financial profit as base or either costing profit as base. Okay, so profit as per cost books. Profit as per cost books. Profit as per cost books is 4,28,000. And then what are the expenses are to be added and what are the expenses should be, incomes should be. Expense should be deducted. Okay. Add add. Okay, we need to check from first. Okay, first one is raw materials. First one is raw materials. In cost books it is recorded as 1 lakh. In financial account it is recorded as 1,20,000. That means in costing books it is undervalued by 20,000. As a result, undervaluation of raw materials, costing profit is increased by 20,000. Now we need to deduct that 20,000. Then work in progress. Even work in progress is also undervalued by 10,000. How it is 10,000? In cost books, it is recorded as 1,30,000. In financial account, it is recorded as 1,40,000. It is undervalued by 10,000. As a result, costing profit is increased by 10,000. Now we need to deduct. Okay, then finished stock. In cost books, it is recorded as 90,000. In financial account, it is recorded as 10,000. Even finished stock is also opening stock of finished goods also undervalued by 10,000. As a result, costing profit is increased by 10,000. Now we need to reduce the profit by 10,000. Then closing stock of raw materials. actually closing stock of raw materials is overvalued by 6,000. As a result, costing profit is increased by 6,000. Now we need to reduce the costing profit by 6,000. Then closing stock, closing work in progress. Closing work in progress is recorded as 74,000 in cost books, but actually it is recorded in financial account as 60,000. As a result, costing profit is increased by 14,000. Now we need to reduce the costing profit by 14,000. Then finished stock, closing stock of finished goods, it is also overvalued by 6,000. In cost books, it is recorded as 1,24,000. In financial account, it is recorded as 1,18,000. As a result, we need to, as a result, costing profit is increased by 6,000. Now we need to reduce the costing profit by 6,000. Okay. Then purchases, so it's an exception. Purchases, wages, and sales are the exception. So we have considered same. Then factory expenses. What about factory expenses? So it is recorded same 4 lakh, 4 lakh. Okay. So no effect. Then interest received. Okay, in financial books, 32,000 is financial profit is increased by 32,000. Now we need to increase the costing profit by also 32,000. Interest received. Interest received. That was the pure financial income. What is this actually? This is actually pure financial income. Interest received. Write the amount. 32,000. Okay, then what about office expenses? Office expenses is undervalued actually. In costing books, it is recorded as 46,000. In financial account, it is recorded as 60,000. It is undervalued by 14,000. As a result, costing profit is increased by 14,000. Now we need to reduce the costing profit by 14,000. Then income tax, that's with regard to financial, that is a pure financial expense. So it is, the financial profit is reduced by 15,000. Now we need to reduce the costing profit by also 15,000. Loss on sale of investment is a financial loss. There is a loss of 17,000 in financial profit. So we need to reduce the costing profit by also 17,000. Then selling expenses. Selling expense in costing books, it is recorded as 90,000. In financial account, it is recorded as 80,000. So costing, financial selling expenses overvalued by 10,000. As a result, financial profit is reduced by 10,000. Now we need to increase the costing profit by 10,000. Okay, overvaluation of selling expenses. Overvaluation of selling expenses. What's the overvaluation? How much it is overvalued? 90,000. 90,000 minus 80,000. It is overvalued by 10,000. Okay, that's all. 32,000 plus 10,000, that is equal to 42,000. This amount to be added. 4,28,000 plus 42,000. 4,28,000 plus 42,000, that is equal to 4,70,000. That is equal to 4,70,000. Then less. Now rest are to be deducted. We have already discussed it. Okay. Undervaluation of opening stock of raw materials. Undervaluation of opening stock of raw materials. Opening stock of raw materials. How much it is undervalued? That is 1,20,000 minus 1,00,000. It's undervalued by 20,000. Then undervaluation of opening work in progress. Undervaluation of opening work in progress. How much it is undervalued? Undervaluation of opening work in progress. One lakh 40 minus 1,30,000. 140,000 minus 130,000. So it is undervalued by 10,000. Then undervaluation of opening stock of finished goods. So how much it is undervalued? It's undervalued by 1 lakh minus 90,000. 1 lakh minus 90,000. 1 lakh minus 90,000. 10,000. It is undervalued by 10,000. Then next thing is about the closing stock. All the closing stock values are overvalued. Then overvaluation of opening stock of raw materials. How much it is overvalued? It is overvalued by 6,000. How about it is 6,000? 86,000 minus 80,000. 86,000 minus 80,000. That is equal to 6,000. Then overvaluation of closing work in progress. Overvaluation of closing stock of raw materials. Then overvaluation of closing work in progress. How much it is overvalued? It is overvalued by 74,000 minus 60,000. 74,000 minus 60,000. Then overvaluation of closing stock of finished goods. Okay, how much it is overvalued? 1,24,000 minus 1,18,000. It is overvalued by 6,000. Then there is an information regarding finished stock is over, purchases, wages, then factory expenses recorded correctly, sales, interest received, we have added. Office expenses, yes, office expenses, undervaluation of office expenses. How much it is undervalued? 60,000 minus 46,000. It's undervalued by 14,000. Then income tax, financial expense, income tax. Then loss on sale of investments. 17,000. Okay, that's all. Make the total 20,000 plus 10,000. Again 10,000. Again next 6,000. Next 14,000. Again 6,000. Again 14,000. Then 15,000. Totally, income tax is not recorded. 17,000. Should be recorded. 17,000. Sorry, when is a loss on sale of investments after income tax? Loss on sale of investments. Its total is 1,12,000. Total is 1,12,000. So financial profit 3,58,000. What is this actually? Profit as per financial books. Profit as per financial books. This is 3,58,000. Yeah, you're observing here profit as per financial books is 3,58,000. So it's clear. It is equal to financial books. So we identified the reason for the variation in profit between the costing books and the financial books. Okay, so this is with regard to this problem. If you have any confusion, you can definitely ask. This is little simplest problem as compared to previous problems, as financial profit is given in the beginning itself. Okay, so thank you so much for watching the class. We will meet in the next class.